Okay, so Tina, you started to tell me the story of how you found the Baha'i Faith. Can you tell me that story?
Well, I was in college, and this I met this woman. I was really guided to her. It was wonderful meeting, and she wasn't a Baha'i, but she had been reading Gleanings, and she'd gotten it from a Baha'i who was married to a Mormon. He didn't want to go to the Mormon church, so he went to her church as a compromise and met her there. He gave her the he said something to her about, would you recognize Jesus if he walked in the room? And she had to think about it. Would I recognize him? What would he be like? So he gave her this book, and she was a career counselor at the college, and we met, and I was a religious studies major and a science major. And one day, she'd become my friend. She said something, and I said, that's not a Christian concept. Where did you get that from? She said, Baha'i. And I said, Baha'i? Oh, do you have something to read? Can you give me something to read on that? And she handed me the book very reluctantly. And I guess she thought I'd think she was strange or something. Because we were both members of this Christian school and we were at a religious college. And I took it home, and my husband and my baby son were upstairs, and they didn't come down and they didn't make any noise. It was a small little apartment, we were just poor students. For about an hour and a half, it was the most time I'd had that whole year since my son was born, to myself. And I sat there and I opened the book, the Gleanings, and the very night that she'd given it to me. And I started at the back of the book, and I slowly went through the pages, and I read everything that she had underlined in all her colored pens. And everything I read, it just penetrated the depths of my soul. And it said, and it gave me all the knowledge and wisdom I'd been looking for, that love, the beauty, and my answers, my it gave me answers. And I knew everything I read was true. And I was in awe the whole time, and I felt like I was in some kind of trance or something. It was as if some invisible angelic force was surrounding me, because I was in a pocket of peace that entire time. I was fully concentrated on the word. Nothing distracted me. I was in another world. And when I came to the beginning of the book, it said that it started in 1844. And I said, 1844? Now I've heard that before. Because I had gone to a Seventh-day Adventist college before this one. I wasn't a Seventh-day Adventist. But it was the closest private little Christian school near my home, and I wanted to go to a Christian school. My mother said, why don't you go to the Seventh-day Adventist college? They're Christians. And we were like almost Mormons, so we were unusual. We were Reorganized Latter-day Saints, not the Utah Mormons, but another Mormon group. And I said, okay, and I went there. This is before I came to the college where I found Baha'u'llah. And at that school, I was recalling that when I went there for a couple quarters, they had written on the blackboard one day in one of my classes, "The Great Disappointment of 1844." Because William Miller, the precursor to the Seventh-day Adventists, he said Christ was coming in 1844. And they were so disappointed because they didn't. And I said, when I first saw that prior to coming to that school I was currently at, I said, 1844, what in the world is that? But you know, I couldn't miss it. He'd written it so large all over the blackboard. I remember the day I was half asleep in school, but I still couldn't miss it. I took that with me. And when I read these writings by Baha'u'llah, and I came to the beginning, I said, 1844. Oh my God. Mm. And then I called my friend. An hour and a half, 2 hours after she'd given me the book, I called her, and I had read in the little history of Gleanings at the beginning that the temple was in Wilmette. And I called her and I said, when are we going to Wilmette? And she said, oh my God, you can't know. I said, know what? She said, I'll be right over. And she drove over like a dash and she came into my door, walked in, and she said, you know who Baha'u'llah is? Now, she wasn't a Baha'i yet, you know. But she'd been reading it for 4 years trying to find something wrong with this faith.
Oh, she'd been reading four years.
4 years she'd been searching different books. I didn't know that at the time. And I said, what do you mean? Who Baha'u'llah is? I didn't get that part yet. All I knew was what I was reading was true. I hadn't heard the name yet. I didn't even read the front of the book where it said Baha'u'llah. All I knew was this was true. And she said, she showed me an identity passage, you know. She had color-coded it. I read that. Oh, Jews, if ye be once again intent on crucifying Christ, crucify me, for he has once more in my person been made manifest unto thee. And I said, oh my God, of course. Because when I, a few years before that, 3 or 4 years before that, I'd spent 2 months in my mother's basement praying about the return of Christ. And that time, out of my mouth, came something that I knew wasn't from me. And I said, oh Lord, reveal the hidden mystery to me.
And amazing.
Heaven and earth shook in my being then. I knew it. I knew it had. But I didn't know what was going to happen. It took a few years. So here it was. And I said, oh, this is it. And my husband came home. And my ex-husband came home. And I was so, and our roommate came home. And I was so excited. And they were so shocked. There I was, I'm a very strong Christian, you know. And this department at the school, when they found out, they just did not know what to do with me. But on Christmas break, they took a trip to Israel. I couldn't afford to go, but they stopped in Haifa as a result. Because I was their best religion major in the school. I had the best grades, I guess. And they were shocked. What happened here? But anyhow, I'm going ahead of myself. So I had this tremendous experience that night, and then some money miraculously came our way within a short time, and we bought a big old conversion van. And we drove to Wilmette on like a pilgrimage during Thanksgiving weekend. And we went temple hopping. We went to all these different temples. And we went to the Hare Krishna temple on Thanksgiving Day. And they invited us to have dinner with the monks. And we told them about Baha'u'llah. A little bit we knew. And I went to the temple. And I signed my card.
The Baha'i Temple.
To the Baha'i Temple. Yes. And I signed my card, and I didn't know anything. I didn't know anything about the central figures. I really didn't know much. I hadn't met a Baha'i, you know. I'd just come into contact with Baha'u'llah through his word.
Right.
And I did meet a Baha'i. We did pick one up on the trip. But I hadn't met any before that. I did hear about the card, you know. And she said, "Oh my God, you're so enthusiastic. I'll let you, go ahead and sign it." Aww. Signed it. And then my friend signed it. Aww. And then her husband, and then my husband. Oh, it turned into be quite a
wow.
Quite a year.
Wow.